Friends, welcome to a new video. Today I'm going to explain niacin or nicotinic acid. What is this niacin and nicotinic acid? This is other name of vitamin B3. Vitamin B3 is a water soluble vitamin, and usually niacin and nicotinic acid is given to treat vitamin B3 deficiency, that is pellagra. And also it is given to treat hypercholesterolemia or increased serum cholesterol level. To treat hypercholesterolemia, you can give this medications, that is nicotinic acid or niacin. Fine. For your international nursing licensing exam, you may get 3 or 4 questions from nicotinic acid. Okay. So, we'll discuss what is this nicotinic acid and what is the dosage and what are the side effects, and while administering this medications, what all thing you have to remember. Okay. So, the medication, the dosage of medications, if you are giving this medicine to treat pellagra, the dosage is 150 to 500 mg/kg. That is very low amount. Fine. So, if you wanted to treat vitamin B3 deficiency, which is called as pellagra, you can start with 150 to 500 mg. Fine. If you are giving or treating the condition which is increased cholesterol, you have to give high dose of vitamin B3, that is niacin, that is 1000 mg to 2000 mg/kg. And the maximum dose is 800 mg. Okay. So please remember the dosage. Maximum dose of vitamin B3, that is niacin, which is 8000 milligram. Fine. So what is the action? This will reduce LDL and triglycerides. Okay. So this will reduce LDL and triglycerides. In the same way, it will increase HDL. This is called as good cholesterol. HDL is good cholesterol and LDL is considered as bad cholesterol, because LDL will adhere with the blood vessels and it causes thrombus. I repeat, LDL is bad cholesterol, HDL is good cholesterol. Okay, why? LDL blood vessel will adhere to you, and later on a thrombus formation will lead to you. So when you administer nicotinic acid, LDL in the alavu, that means bad cholesterol in the alavu korchu, coronary artery disease polulla cardiac disorders in the chance reduce. Okay, fine. So it will reduce LDL and triglycerides, and that will increase high density lipoprotein or cholesterol. Fine. Okay, this medication has various side effects. So we will discuss what are the side effects of medications. Number one is flushing. Okay, so this medication causes flushing and headache, hepatotoxicity, pruritus and gout, vision problems and irregular heartbeat. I repeat, side effect of this medication is flushing. That is the initial thing. Okay, flushing will happen, there will be headache, there will be hepatotoxicity, pruritus, gout, that is there will increase uric acid level, and vision problem and irregular heartbeat. Fine, these are the side effects. Okay, please remember all of these side effects. Fine. Okay, next what we will discuss is, while administering this medications, what are the basic things that you should remember? Okay, being a registered nurse, what are the things you should remember while administering nicotinic acid? For all of your international nursing exam, you may get 3 or 4 questions related with this. Okay, so we will discuss the nursing actions while administering this medications. Okay, already we said the first side effect of this medication is flushing. So in order to reduce flushing, what are the things that you need to remember? Number one, never administer this medications on empty stomach. So the second point, okay, avoid taking on empty stomach because it worsen flushing or it increases flushing. So to reduce flushing, what you can do is you can take this medications with meal, But please remember, the meal should be low fat in diet. Okay, so the meal should be low fat. Okay, so administer with a low fat diet. Never administer on empty stomach. Okay, because it causes flushing. To prevent flushing, what you can do is administer NSAIDs and aspirin. Okay, you can administer NSAID and aspirin to prevent flushing. Usually this flushing will be expected in the initial time of administration. But if patient has tolerated one or two dose or 1 week dose, usually the symptoms, the severity of flushing can be reduced. And certain studies reveals that apple sauce or the ripe apple contain pectin, and that will reduce flushing. Okay, so apple sauce will reduce flushing. So before administering this, the patient can take apple sauce. Okay, and there are certain situations where flushing will worsen. For example, if a patient is taking alcohol, that increases flushing. Okay, so you need to ask the patient to stop alcohol in order to reduce chances of flushing. Okay, so the situation which will reduce flushing and the situations where it will worsen the flushing. Alcohol will worsen the flushing and alcohol salts or medications like NSAIDs and aspirin will reduce flushing. So please remember that. And already we have discussed the side effect like irregular heartbeat, hepatotoxicity, gout. Okay. So related with that, please remember this particular point. This assess for gout, liver disease and heart disease, because it has side effects like gout. So it will increase uric acid. So if patient is having increased the uric acid level, never administer this medication. So you have to select for any other alternative. And if patient has liver disease, never administer. And if patient has any heart disease, if the symptoms will worsen because it has irregular heartbeat, there is a side effect. Okay, so before administering nicotinic acid, please make sure that the patient is free from gout, liver disease and cardiac disorders. Okay. And next is, never take these medications as chewable tablet and crushing. Never crush these tablets and never chew. Always swallow these tablets. Okay. Okay. And next is, take missed dose when you remember. For example, the patient has been receiving these medications like VD or QID. And one dose, the patient, unfortunately, the patient forgot to take one dose. So when you remember the missed dose, you can immediately take the medication. But if this time is very close about the next dose, you can just completely skip the medications. Okay, so that point is very important. And there are other medications, lipid lowering agents like cholesteramine and Zocar. All those medications will interact with nicotinic acid. So never administer nicotinic acid along with cholesteramine. But if the patient really demands this medication or patient's condition really requires this medication, obviously yes, you can take these medications, but it should be in a different time. For example, if patient has taken cholesteramine or any type of any other lipid lowering agent, you can administer Niacin after 4 to 6 hours after the initial dose of cholesteramine. Never administer all of these medications altogether. Fine. So better take single medications, but if there is a standing order or the patient's health condition really requires this both of medications, never administer together. You can give these medications wide apart. Fine. This is something, it is very, very important. So